Hello students, welcome to the lecture series on the circuits and networks or networks theory. So today we will see what is a mesh analysis. So for mesh analysis, it is also called as a loop analysis. So in mesh analysis or loop analysis, we have to firstly identify the number of loops in the circuits. The loops is nothing but what the connection of n number of branches that should be connected at different nodes, and the loops is basically a circular electrical network which has a current passing through it. It is in anti-clockwise or clockwise direction, depends on the number of sources connected. Here firstly we will see mesh analysis. It is also called as a loop analysis, and in this one we have to use Kirchhoff's voltage law. For always remember, in mesh analysis or loop analysis we have to use the Kirchhoff's voltage law. Here we will see the simple steps to write the loop, how to solve the loop equations, or steps to solve the problem of mesh analysis or loop analysis. Here you must know, here we have to use the KVL, that is the Kirchhoff's law, voltage law for loop or mesh analysis. So this is a circuit. So in this circuit we have the three resistance. One is 5 ohm, another is 30 ohm, and another is 10 ohm. Here we have the two voltage sources. V1, that value will be 20 volts, and V2, that value is 80 volts. So firstly, identify the number of loops in the circuits. Here how we have to identify the number of loops in the circuits. Firstly, just check it. Here one branch is there, this one is another branch, and this one is the ground branch. So here this particular one square, it will be form one loop. So for this I will mention as a first loop. Similarly for this one, again it will be a second loops. So I have to write down the number of loops. First I have to complete it, that is identify the number of loops in the circuit. So there are the two loops are there. Again the second point is mark the direction of current in the circuits, depends on the voltage source. So always remember, the current is flowing from plus to minus. So that is our indication, that current is always flowing from what, plus to minus is there. So here just check it, V1 is 20 volts, it has a polarity of plus to minus. So current is always flowing from here, this loop, plus to minus is there. So I will write down this one as a plus to minus. Again for this one, again here current is flowing from plus to minus, but here the polarity is reverse, minus to plus. So here this plus is there, it will be flowing from like this one, plus to minus. So I will write down plus to minus like this. So for first loop I will mention as a I1, and for second loop I will mention the current as a I2 is there. So mark the direction of current in the circuit. Okay, afterwards we have to write down the loop or mesh equation by applying KVL to the circuit. So we will see how to apply the KVL for these circuits. Okay, so KVL will be applied for the particular loop, for first loop as well as for the second loop. So firstly we will see how many loops or mesh are there. Here there are the two loops are there, so the number of equation is also 2. So number of equation must be equal to the number of loops. So loops must be equal to 2. So similarly the equation is also equal to 2 is there. After writing the equations by applying a KVL, we have to solve the mesh equations by using simple method or by using the Cramer's rule. So what is Cramer's rule or simple method is there, that I will explain it afterwards. But just remember, after writing the loop or mesh equations, we have to apply the KVL for the circuit, and we have to solve the mesh equations by using a simple method or Cramer's rule. I think many students will complete this Cramer's rule in the maths, And after the applying the Cramer's rule, we have to find out the value of I1 and I2. That is a loop current first and loop current second is there. And find the value of I and V in the loop or mesh is there. Here we have to find out the value of I and V in mesh and loops. So we will see how to apply the particular loop or mesh to the circuits and how to solve the problems. So assume this is a circuit. Here plus minus, minus plus. Here I will write down first V1, 5 volts. Here I will write down 80 V2. Here 5 ohm, 30 ohm and 10 ohm. So just remember, first we will identify the number of loops. So here there are two loops are there, first and second. So directly I will write down I1 and here I will write down the I2. So I1 and I2. Okay. After this one, we will check how many loops are there. There are two loops. So, two loops must be equal to two equations. So, just remember here, for this 5 ohm, I1 is flowing like this. The current is start like this one. It will become like this. Okay. So, for this one, 5 ohm, I1 is flowing. For this 10 ohm, so looking from this side, there are two currents are there. One is I1 and another is what? I2. So I1 is flowing like this one and I2 is flowing like this one. Similarly, it will come from this side. Okay. So for this loop, the major current is what? I1. And for this one, the major current is what? I2. So again here, just remember, for this 30 ohm, the current only flowing is what? I2. It will become to 80. And again, if it will be come to here, that is 10 ohm. So here the major current is what? I2 and the minor current is what? I1. So here the equation is what? I2 minus I1. For this one, it will be what? I1 minus I2 is there. So for like this, we will write down here the two value of currents. Here the current is what? I1 minus I2. And for this one, I2 minus I1. Just make the bracket. Afterwards, while solving the problem, we will get the results. Now we have to apply the what? We have to apply the KVL for this circuit. So apply KVL for first loop. So start from here. So always remember the current is flowing from where? Plus 2, minus is there. So first I will start from here minus 5 I1. Because why we will take minus? Because the current is flowing from where? Plus 2, minus. The current is flowing from where to where? Plus 2, minus. So there must be drop in potential. So I will take it minus. Again I will come it here minus. But here 10. Into the value of current. Just remember, in this 10 ohm, there are two currents are flowing. One is I1 and another is what? I2. So I will write down I1 minus I2. Again, after completion of this, I will come it here. Here we have the sign of minus 5 volts equal to 0. So I will solve this. Just remember, this 5 I1 minus 5 I1 minus 10 I1 plus 10 I2 equal to 5 volts. Okay, this 5 will become on another side. So minus 5, minus 10, minus 15 I1 plus 10 I2 equal to 5 is there. This is a first current. This is a first equation, loop equations. So I will write down here in one side that what will be the first equations. Here the first equation is 50 I1 plus 10 I2. Equal to what? 5. Afterwards, we'll drop this. Now we have to apply the KVL for second loops. After applying the KVL for second loop, I will start from here. So just remember, minus 30. Here the major current is what? I2. Here I will come, there is a minus sign, minus 80. Again it will be come like this one here, minus 10. Now here the current is what? I2 minus I1, because the major current is what? I2, and the minor current is I1. So here I2 minus I1 equal to 0. So I will solve it, minus 30 I2, this 80 will become on another side, minus 10 I2 plus this minus minus will plus equal to this 80 will come on another side, that should be 80. Okay, so here minus 23 I2 plus 10 I1 equal to 80. So this is our equation number second. So I will write down here, that is minus 23 I2 plus 10 I1 equal to 80. Here you should make the habit that you should write down the equation always in terms of I1 and I2. So here I will write down this 10 I1 minus this 23 I2 equal to what? 80. Okay, so here I will write down plus 10 I1 minus 23 I2 equal to what? 80 is there. This is the two equations. So how we will find out these two equations? So I will rub this, keep these two equation as it is. So first equation is 50 I1 plus 10 I2 equal to 5, and another is plus 10 I1 minus 23 I2 equal to what? 80. So what I will do, I will multiply first equation by 10 and another equation by 50, and we have to add this. So here for first equation, this is the simple method, already you will see in the 8 or 9 standards. So I will multiply this with 10, because here 10 is there and here 15 is there. So same value I have to multiply for this one, that is 15, and this value will be multiplied for this one. So I1, I1 will get cancelled and we will get the value of I2. Okay. So what we will do, minus first equation multiply by 10 means 150 I1 plus 100 I2 equal to 50, and second one is again plus 150 I1 minus, so 23 into 50. What equation is there? Is 345. You will just calculate. Again one more zero. Okay, so we'll just cancel it, and from this one 100 is again cancelled. So here we'll get 245 I2 equal to 1250. We'll add this. Okay, so I2 equal to what? 1250 divided by 245 ampere. You just calculate it. I will do rough calculation of I1 and I2. Already you must clear the concept that how we will write down the loop equation, that is I1 and I2 and all this one. So afterwards this I1 will be put in equation number 1. So here we have the equation number 1. So I will write down here what will be the equation number 1. 50 I1 plus 10 I2 equal to 5. So I will put this here, minus 50 I1 plus 10 into 1250 divided by 245 equal to 5. So here you will get I1 equal to, you just solve it and send me the results. Okay, so today we'll see what is mesh analysis and or loop analysis and how we have to solve the problems by using the simple methods. So in this method or in this particular analysis, first we have to identify the number of loops, then after identifying the number of loops, we have to apply the KVL for each loops. After applying the Kirchhoff's voltage law for each loops in the circuits, we have to write down the loop equations, and by using this is a simple method, we have to find out the value of I1 and I2. Afterwards we will go for the Cramer's rule. Thank you.